all the difficulties that you faced in publishing this particular book, because we were in touch on phone.
Right.
You sitting in America fretting over all the difficulties you were right. having with your publisher, who was being forced to withdraw this manuscript and junk it. Who was creating all the trouble? So, what were the obstructions and what were their reasons?
So the thing starts, the problem starts in the Bangkok Sanskrit Congress in 2015, June. I was invited to be a keynote speaker and I spoke on this book. It was a huge success among the Indians and the Southeast Asian people. They loved it and they said, this is a book we all want to read. The Thai royal princess, who's the head of that committee, the one that organizes all this, the head patron, I should say, sent a message saying she really enjoyed this and would love to get lots of copies of this book. So the I would say the Asian side, the people who consider it their tradition, that I've called the insiders, they loved it at that event. The Westerners who were present, they were not happy at all and started tweeting and started sending messages, who is this guy, he is not qualified, he doesn't have the authority, and what is it, what, you know, sort of taking shots at me. And then this turned into more and more personal stuff. And then one evangelist based in Princeton turned it into a personal attack that I lacked integrity and I didn't know how to write properly, I didn't know how to cite quotations properly, my previous books were flawed in this particular respect. So then they started this petition and they got 250 signatures, but important people signing. And we signed, had a counter petition that you put up, and we got 11,000.
That's
so
right.
We had 40 signatures for every one of them. I mean, they should have just understood the message that the public has spoken and keep their mouth shut. But then they turned it into media. And there was an article in Hindu, the article in Business Standard. None of them probably read any of the books.
Against you.
Against me.
Without and, talking to you?
Without talking to me. And I wrote to them saying I would like to write to respond and never heard back. Someone introduced me to Ravi, who's N. Ram's brother. And he was a very decent man. We spoke on the phone. And I gave him a lot of my evidence, and he hadn't thought of it, and he hadn't. He says that he didn't know about it. So I said, wouldn't the reader be better informed if you gave him my side of the story? So he said, why don't you write me all this, and I will pass it on to Malini, who is the new editor-in-chief. And he would recommend that I should be given a chance to respond. Malini didn't want anything to do with it, me allowing me to have a response. In fact, when I pushed
they completely blanked it out?
Blanked it out. And nothing.
So right to, I mean,
no right
it's
to
it's critique behind your back.
Yes.
In absentia.
Correct.
They're not willing to give you space
in
to
respond. Yeah. In fact, after lobbying enough times, that why am I not being given the right? And it should be fair play. I should be given a right. You should give me the space. They never even wrote to me saying we're rejecting. They wrote it. They wrote an article in their newspaper saying the editor has exercised her discretion to deny Rajiv Malhotra, to deny Rajiv Malhotra his claim to give his point of view.
That's bizarre. You could have gone to press council.
But I don't know how these things work.
Really? This is unprecedented. So I really think you should
now,
because
I
mean, she did that to me as well.
Yeah. And,
she told me to my face at one time, all these protectors of Indian tolerance
right.
and tradition. She told me to my face, she would never let me get published
yeah.
because I wrote something that bugged her and
right.
it annoyed her
they're
friends
so
in the
city. So petty, so immature, and once they have something you said that they don't like, then for life you are blacklisted. I mean, this is one of the top two newspapers in the country. It's a disgrace that we call this free speech. I mean, free speech is at the discretion of the editors and gatekeepers, and they tend to be people who are not very fond of me. So anyway, so this went on, and then when all this died down, the publisher was very nervous because they also were doing a lot of lobbying to the publisher, asking that they should not publish my books, I'm a bad fellow, all kinds of problems with me. And so I just stayed quiet for a few months, let this thing quieten down. And then the publisher and I started working again to, you know, get this going. And the publisher wanted me to take a lot of precautions to make sure I'm not saying anything that would be personal. We are very sure that they've had many lawyers look at it, many different people look. This book has been checked out more than probably any other book I know of by lawyers here in India, by legal people overseas. By the publisher to make sure that, you know, I'm not doing anything defamatory, and I'm not. I'm very courteous, and I'm just disagreeing with their positions. And so then finally the thing went to press. After many, many rounds of let's remove this, or let's water down this, let's not be too strong on that. And I'm very happy to be more and more courteous. In fact, I sent this to at least 10 people of my own to ask them, do you think there's anything rude or incorrect or something out of line? And I would give the benefit of doubt to anybody who said, well, you know, this one, you really don't need to say it. You've said enough of it. So I watered it down in order to be courteous, not removing the actual substance of my argument, but just the tone. However, even after all of this, when the book went to press, it started printing. Copies were printing. Then I get a call when my wife and I are in a holiday in Florida. After a few years, we finally thought maybe I should have a break. Within a 2-3 nights, I got a call from Delhi that the printing has been stopped because some issues have been raised again, some last minute more issues. And this is ridiculous. You can get some lawyer to write some letter saying, has he, not pinpointing any particular paragraph or sentence, but just raising rhetorical issues. Has he checked with Sheldon Pollack to make sure he will not be objecting? Has he received his permission to criticize him? And I said, a ridiculous thing to say. No one could be criticized.
Did they take your permission when they banged at you at various
forums? You could never criticize a person if the rules were that you need their permission. So this is so ridiculous. I said, well, if they don't agree with my criticism, they can write their rebuttal. That should be how it is. But the fear was that, okay, maybe they'll create another ruckus like the one they did in the summer. And do we really want to be in a, you know, mudslinging battle? And so I made some further changes, and I made some young people in Princeton, two of them, work 14 hours nonstop because my eyes are not that good, looking through all kind of little details and checking here, checking there, producing lists and all that. So then it went back to press. So this is the period I was very upset about because I had set up 23 appointments for events. And you know,
to do with the release of the book.
To do the release and distinguish people and lots of forums. And, you know, I have volunteers. They put in so much time and energy. I have in Bangalore, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Mumbai and Delhi, 5 teams. And they're doing it as a passion. And for them to raise the money, book halls, pay for the halls, get video cameras, you know, all of that that they were doing. I mean, it wasn't a fun thing for me to go and say to them that maybe the book won't happen or maybe it'll be delayed for a long time. So I was in panic mode because I felt, you know, in case the book is cancelled for now and then has to be brought back, you know, it will be very damaging for me. So I decided that in parallel I should look for alternatives just as a backup. If everything is back on track, nothing like it. But if it's not back on track, I should have some alternatives because I cannot destroy my life as a writer. And so luckily things were okay. We got the book. We got thousands of copies. And the book has done extremely well. The publisher is very happy. We've sold out the first print run and much of the second print run.